It's Yusi Lams here. You're welcome to today's episode. As you can see, I had a studio makeover. I hope you like it. If you're watching this video, it means you've rooted your phone and you want to know what to do after rooting your phone. Or you want to weigh the advantages against the risks of rooting your Android smartphone. You may be that person who has no idea about rooting. If you are that person, hit the link up here to watch my previous video where I explained rooting. If this is your first time here in my channel, hit the subscribe button below to subscribe to my channel and also turn on the post notification to get weekly updates of my videos. Straight into the video, there's a lot of things to do after rooting your Android smartphone. However, for the sake of time, I'll be focusing on those things that improve battery, sound, and the entire Android usage experience. If you're a normal Android user who wants these improvements, the first 5 things I'm going to discuss would be just sufficient for you. But if you're a crazy Android enthusiast like myself, you would most probably be interested in the last 3. The very first thing to do after rooting your phone is to debloat your phone. Yes, remove those useless system apps. If you're rooted with Magisk, you can do this by going to the download section of Magisk, search and install debloater. Make sure that the bloater you're installing has terminal emulator in parentheses. This is so because to debloat your software with this module, you need to install the terminal emulator app. My favorite terminal emulator app is the Termix. You can install it from Play Store. Just go to Play Store, search and install it. After installation, launch Termix. Type the command su. A super user request will pop up. Accept the request. Grant it super user permission. After that, type the command debloat and then enter. This would give you the debloat options from which you can choose. Another alternative to debloating your software is a system app remover, which you can install from Play Store. The free version of the app contains advertisements. If you're cool with that, you can use it. In this app, it is quite easy. Once you launch the app, a super user request will pop up. Grant it super user request and choose the apps you wish to debloat. Voila, as easy as that. Do note that the system app remover is not compatible with all devices, so I would recommend you use the debloater app from the Magisk app. Secondly, install sound mods. The most popular sound mod is the Viper for Android FX. You can install this from the Magisk download section. Go there, download it and install it. The Viper for Android FX boasts some features like the audio gain feature. The audio gain feature allows you to increase your maximum volume for the speakers, headphones, USB devices, or Bluetooth audio devices connected. This is useful for devices with low maximum volume. The Viper for Android FX also allows you to add reverberation. You can add reverb to your audio output. There's also Surround Plus Sound, which works for audio from your headphones, Bluetooth, or USB audio devices. This adds a surround sound to your audio. You also have addition of bass and clarity to audio coming out from your headphones, Bluetooth, or USB audio devices. Another alternative for the Viper for Android FX is Dolby Atmos, which you can try out. Google it and try it out. The third thing to do is to install apps to SD or links to SD. I bet you hate that low storage space notification, even when you have an external SD. Well, don't worry anymore, because if you have an external SD card with a rooted Android phone, your storage space is running out situation is fixed. How do you do this? With apps to SD and links to SD, you can link your apps and files to your external SD card. Apps to SD offers more features than the links to SD, but both apps require a paid version to unlock more features. To use any of these apps, you need to partition your external memory card. You can do this by installing the mini partition tool on your Windows operating system or the Mac OS. Use this tool to partition your SD card into 2. The first partition should be in a primary partition, that is FAT32, while the second partition may be in either the X3 or X4, the EXE3 or EXE4, however you pronounce it. Now, once you're done with partitioning, you need to put the memory card in your device. Install links to SD or the apps to SD. They will require root permission, and once you launch the apps, they would immediately recognize that your memory card is now partitioned into 2. Then they would create a mount script to mount the partition every time you boot your device. Now, this will allow you to move the apps to your SD card. You can simply choose the apps you wish to move to your SD card, move them to your SD card, and voila, there is now space on your device. Anyways, let's go over to the fourth thing to do. Fourthly, install Adaway. I don't know about you, but I hate advertisements in some apps, especially those ones that cover the entire screen. Well, if you hate ads like me, install Adaway to get rid of them. Do note, Adaway is not entirely flawless, as in some apps, it replaces the ads with a black banner, which doesn't actually solve anything. Adaway isn't available in the Google Play Store for obvious reasons. Google doesn't want you to block ads. Even I don't want you to block ads in YouTube. Well, if you want to use Adaway, simply install it from the link I'll leave in the description. After installation, launch it and apply ads blocking. But before you do that, you need to enable systemless host files in a Magisk settings. Number 5. Install Greenify app. The Greenify app hibernates apps running in the background. In the Android system, when you open an app, that app runs in the foreground. Whereas, there are other apps running in the background which you can't see, like the WhatsApp which runs in the background to receive new messages. You can install Greenify app from the Google Play Store, grant it root access, and click the plus sign to add apps which you want to remove. You need to pay to get features like hibernating system apps, and also you would require exposed module, which we are going to discuss as the sixth thing. Number 6. Install exposed framework. Exposed framework allows you to add add-ons called modules to your system which modifies your system and apps. You can install exposed framework for Android 7 and below by going to the Magisk download section, search for exposed framework, install it and reboot your device. You would need the exposed installer for Magisk, which I would leave the link to in the description, to use exposed framework for Android 7 and below. If you are using Android 8 and above, you would need to install RiruCore from the same Magisk download section, and also you would need to install RiruAd Expose, which is also in the Magisk download section. And third, you would need to install the Ed Exposed Manager, which I'll leave the link to in the description too, to use Exposed Framework on your device. Now, once you have Exposed installed, you can simply launch the Exposed installer for Magisk if you're using Android 7 and below, or the Ed Exposed Manager for the Android 8 and above. Launch the app, go to the download section. Some of my favorite modules are the X-Insta, which allows you to download photos and videos from Instagram app. Another one is the Min Guard, which blocks ads completely, even way better than the Adaway. Another one is the iFont, which allows you to change the font of your device. It can also allow you to set different fonts for different apps. There are many exposed modules to explore. Feel free to explore them and install them. Some of them are pretty great. You should know that Expose extends your boot time, which means your device will take longer to boot up, and Expose may cause lag in low-end devices. Number 7 is installing the Kali Linux OS. Yes, you heard me right. This might be too much for your device. But as I said, the last 3 things to do would only be done by someone who is an extremely crazy enthusiast like myself. The Kali Linux is a great OS for pen testing. Pen testing is a shortened form of penetration testing. Kali Linux can be used to test how penetrable your operating system is. An example of this is the Wi-Fi, which can be used to hack Wi-Fis. Feel free to test out the Kali Linux. You can install the Kali Linux in the Magisk download section. Simply search Kali Net Hunter, install it, and fiddle with it. Last thing to do is to install a custom ROM. I bet you didn't expect this to come in last. Custom ROMs are great, but stock Android is pretty good too these days. In the earlier days of Android, you'd need a custom ROM to get more features, but now stock ROMs are also doing very good. If you are using an older version of Android, installing a custom ROM would get you a recent version of Android and also allow you to get recent features. There are many custom ROMs out there. Some of the very good ones are the Resurrection Remix, the Paranoid OS, the Lineage OS, the Cyanogen Mod, the Renovate ICE, and so much more. Feel free to explore the custom ROMs. You can install your custom ROM by simply doing a Google search of the custom ROM for your specific device. The xdadevelopers.com is a great site to get custom ROMs for your device. Check it out and tell me how it goes. We've come to an end of this video. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button. Tell me which one of the things I mentioned you're going to try, and let me know how it goes afterwards in the comment section. Exploration is key to discovery. The more you explore, the more you discover. It's Yusilamse once again. Follow me on other social media, specifically Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. See you in my next video.